Welcome, everybody, to Woody's World. I'm Woody Walters, and I just want to give you a simple breakdown of Photoshop. And we're going to call this Photoshop 101, or things you should know about Photoshop in order to get peak performance out of it, in order for your workflow to be a lot easier for you. So I just want to explain this to you in layman terms and just some facts that you really should know about Photoshop. First of all, Photoshop only does two things. It selects and it manipulates. And what I mean by that is that I can make a selection of something and I can manipulate it. I can change its color, I can change its size, I can change whatever I want to do to it. And so just know that. The problem is that there's 9 million ways to select something from Photoshop and about 100 million ways to manipulate it. I always kind of laugh because, you know, I've been doing Photoshop for over, 17 years now, and I cannot claim myself a master of Photoshop. The program is just so intense and so involved. I don't think anyone is truly a master at Photoshop, just because of it's like saying, you know everything there is about music, you know everything there is about photography. And no, I'm sorry, you don't. You just don't, and I don't care how smart you are. So I just want to break this down into simple terms. Now, depending on what Photoshop you are using will determine on how much Photoshop wants from your computer as far as software, hardware, etc. And Photoshop is very, very heavy duty when it comes to hardware in your computer. You cannot give it enough RAM. You cannot give it enough scratch disk with all the engines that Photoshop uses, either in their filters or the manipulation of Photoshop. It wants more and more and more and more from you. And so you got to know that. So let's just break this down real simple here. First of all, there's the file menu, and that's at the top, and it's always at the top. And here you have your file, you have your open, you have your bridge, you have saving, you have import and export and scripts and print one and etc. Next you have edit, and edit is very important because this is where you're going to find your preferences too. But edit is where you're going to be able to transform your elements, or you know, puppet warp or your elements, where you're going to be able to define brush presets, define patterns, and just there's all these different settings that you have here, and you got to know about it. And we're going to come back to this in just a minute here. Then you have image, and image is very important because this is where you find out what your image quality is. Right now you can see I have this image is 16 by 20 by 240, and really that should be 250, 300. But it tells you the size of your image and the resolution of your image, and this is also very, very critical to understand. And so, you know, that's under image, and there's a lot of other things too. Canvas size, image rotation, your auto color, your adjustments, where you do all your brightness and contrast, your levels, your curves, your exposures, your hue and saturation, your black and white, your channels, which I'll get into here in just a minute, your invert, your posterization, just so much you can do in these. And I can't go through every little item because this video would be too long, but I just want to show you these. And so now you got your layers, and these are layers. And if you look here, and I'm just going to show you real quick. If you look here, I can turn on and off all these layers, and now you can see how the image was actually made. And if I just continue to do that, you can see these in layers, and that's also your F7 key. So if you don't have your layers palette up, press the F7 key and it will come up for you. And so you can just see now that I'm just working in layers and to create this image, and it just slowly comes together. And these are what I call elements. And elements are really neat because you can just, whatever you can think of now, you can create using in Photoshop. And so that's in your layers. And this is also where you get your layers mask, your vector mask, your smart objects, your group layers, arranging. You can merge layers down. You can merge visibles. You can flatten the image, which would take all these layers and put them on just one layer. And then you have your type tool. And your type is a different language with Photoshop. There's two types of artwork that are in Photoshop. There's raster art, and then there's what's called vector art. In vector art, if I take my pen tool here and I click, you're going to see that it goes from one point to the next point to the next point to the next point, and these are called anchor points. And so that's all fine and dandy and everything, but vector art only sees from point A to point B. It doesn't matter if you're working on a billboard or if you're working on a postage stamp. Photoshop just sees from one point to the next point, and it takes very little memory for Photoshop to do that. Then there's something that's called raster art, and raster art is dots per inch or pixels per inch. And so the more pixels you have, the more floating numbers that Photoshop has to remember. And Photoshop, any computer, only talks to itself using zeros and one. So if I zoom up here and I start to look at this girl's face, and you can see her face here, and you can see the sweat, every little thing that Photoshop sees in here is in pixels. And so if I grab her eye, then Photoshop's got to remember every little pixel that's in that eye. And if I start really blowing this up, you can start to see the pixels in here. And Photoshop's got to remember that. It's got to know each shade of color. And basically, it works like this. There's 256 shades of red, 256 shades of green, and 256 shades of blue. And if you times that 256 by 200 by 56 by 200 by 56, you get 16.7 million colors. And that's a lot for Photoshop to have to track and to remember. So Photoshop looks at those pixels and it has to assign a number to each and every one of those pixels, which is why it's so demanding on your computer hardware for Photoshop to be able to manipulate and to select and to do what you're asking it to do. And so whenever you see that hourglass come up or that little circle, you know, timing, that's Photoshop thinking. And you shouldn't get mad at your computer. You should be petting it, saying thank you for, you know, being able to organize all this and be able to do what I'm asking you to do in Photoshop. So I just want to talk about that. And then you have your selection tools where you can select, you can deselect, you can select by color range. Then you have all your filters. And this is another thing that here in this area, you just want to play. And you know, you can distort an image, you can add noise to it, you can sharpen it, you can stylize it, you can liquefy it. Now, in the newer versions of Photoshop, liquefy and a lot of the filters up here have their own engines to drive that. And it's just, again, it's so demanding on your computer. Then you have view where you can, you know, zoom in, you can zoom out, you can do actual print size if you want to see the actual size of the image and so on. I don't really like that, so I'm going to leave it right here. But you have all of these, and then you have your windows, and this is where you get all your other little toolbars, like your actions, your adjustments, your brush presets, your channels, your clone sources, your histogram, your history, your info, layer comps, and da 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 da. And you know, if I want my swatches, I can pull up my swatches. Now I can pick my colors here, and I don't like my toolbar to be docked. And the newer versions of Photoshop gives you a dock toolbar, and I like the old toolbars, so I set it like this. And so if I click on a color here now, you'll see that that color changes to that swatch of whatever color it is, and you can see that right here. Now, Photoshop also defaults to black and white, which we're going to talk about in a little bit. But right now, I just want you to know about the file menu. And now, if you look underneath here, depending on what tool you're in, it will give you your options for your tool that you're in. Right now, I'm in my lasso tool. You can see that here. You can see that I have these little objects here, which means select. This means to add to a selection. This means to subtract a selection. This means to intersect with a selection. And you can see here I have a feather radius. The higher number the feather radius is, the softer the edge is going to be. So right now I'm just going to set that on zero. And I just want you to see this. And we're just going to do a new layer here. So I'm going to come down here, click on a new layer. And I'm going to grab this. I'm just going to make a selection. Then I'm going to grab my brush. I'm going to paint on that. You can see that I have a very sharp definitive edge line here. So now I'm going to undo that, and now I'm going to grab my selection. I'm going to do a selection of 33. What the hey? And now I'm going to do a selection of that. I'm going to grab my same brush again. I'm going to paint on that, and you can see that I have a very soft edge that's going around there, and you can see that right there. So your feather radius is very dependent upon what number you have in your option bar that's going to be here. And that's, this option bar is for any tool that you get in. Right now you can see I'm in paintbrush mode. I have a diameter of a 600 diameter circle. If I hold down my bracket keys, I can enlarge that. Now I'm at 2100, and if I hold down the left bracket key, I can make it smaller, and now I'm at 150. Your mode, and these are different modes, and this is something you're going to have to play with to really kind of understand how all the different modes of your brush work. But for right now, I'm just going to leave it as mode. Then you have your capacity, which I always set at 100%, and then I always just play with my flow rate. And usually when I'm trying to mask something out, and let me just grab this girl again, I'm going to mask mode because I'm clicking on this little black icon here, and now I'm just going to start masking out her face. I'm at 17, and you can see here that when I start to paint, she starts to disappear, and it doesn't matter where. You can see that the ball is behind her in that, and unfortunately I have another paint swab on here, so let me take some of that out right here. And now you can see that I'm painting out her face, and you can see the ball behind her. And now if I go to white, and this is why Photoshop defaults to black and white. So now if I go to white, I can come back in here and paint her face back in. And that's a little masking thing, and that's why Photoshop defaults to that black and white arrow here, is so you can do your masking, and that's very, very important to understand. And you can switch that by just doing this. And so there's so much to all of this, but I just want to, you know, keep it in mind of what you got here. And so this is what we call the desktop. And so you have your file menus, you have your option toolbars, depending on what tool you're in, the tool that you're in. You have your toolbar, and you'll see here on your toolbar, and I just want to break this up right now. You'll see right here in your toolbar, Photoshop breaks this down, if you have it in double way, into 1, 2, 3, 4 different basic outlays for the toolbar. Your first top part of your toolbar is all your selection tools. You have your marquee tool that will do squares and circles. If you left click on it and just hold it, you can see that now I can get a circle one done over here, or I can go back to the square one. You have your lasso tool, and your lasso tool has your lasso, your polygon lasso, and then your magnetic lasso. And these are different type of selection tools that you have here. You have your magic wand tools. So if I was in the ball and I wanted to click on the ball, I can click on that, and then by holding the shift key down, I can just come over here and just really start selecting different areas of the ball. And you can see all that here, and that magic wand. And you have your crop tool, and then you have your eyedropper. And your eyedropper is to be able to select different colors that are within your layers here. And you can see that when I click on this, it's changing to whatever color that is that I'm clicking on. And so that's that. And then you have what I call your paint tools. And this is where you find your healing brush, your clone tool, your eraser, your blur tool, your paint brush, which is also your pencil brush, and your color replacement brush and mixer brush. You have your art brush, you have your gradients, and then you have your dodge tool, your burn tool, and your sponge tool. And then we have what I call your vector tools, and this is where your pen tool is at, where your type tool is at, and your shape tools are at. And then we have what I call the masking portion of Photoshop, and that's again where your swatches are, where you can pick your colors, but also where you can set your defaults so you can do masking, as far as making it an image, subtract from an image by taking it away. And again, if I come up to here and I start to play here, you can see that her face starts to, you know, be taken away here. So I just want to show you all that and let you know. And then you have what I call your desktop. And this is your desktop. And if you press your F key, you will see that Photoshop goes from desktop to what I call close desktop, and then it has a display mode, which turns your screen black so you can just look at your image. Right now I'm in window mode, and if I try to move this, I can't. But if I go F again, now I can position the image anywhere on the desktop. And so you have your window mode, and then you have your desktop mode, and then you have your display mode, which you can move it also to any image or anywhere on the desktop. But I like this black background in the background here. And so I just want to get you familiarized with the layout of Photoshop and everything that we have here. And then I'm going to pause here, and we're going to go on to part 2 of this.